just write down one more reaction here.
CH3, CH2, same reagent I'm taking. CCH3, CH3, and Br here. Now the base is okay. The solvent we have salt of this, so K minus K plus also you can write Na plus. Okay. So since it is a bulky base, right? This bulky base forms what product? CH3 CH double bond CCH3 CH3, and the another product is CH3 CH2 C double bond CH2 CH3. So this is the major product. Hoffman is the major product here. The reason of this is what? Because this is again a bulky base, large base. So this O minus has more tendency to take hydrogen from this carbon, because this methyl group also repels this group to attack onto this hydrogen. So inside, what is the difference this carbon we have? Here we have three hydrogen, and here we have one methyl group. So this U minus, O minus, when it tries to attack or takes this hydrogen atom, this methyl will produce some repulsion to this group. But here we have hydrogen only, CH2 and H. So hydrogen repulsion will be less. That's why it has more tendency to take hydrogen from this carbon. And hence this product is dominating major product. Okay? So because of bulkiness of this group, the hindrance of methyl group and this will be more here. Hence, the extraction of H plus from this carbon is difficult. Hence, we get Hoffman as the major product.
So this repulsion of hydrogen.
Here we have hydrogen, which is negligible, yeah. But here we have methyl repulsion. So obviously repulsion of methyl is more than hydrogen. That's why this problem. Okay, so you have to memorize this. Large base, Hoffman is the major product. Next point to write down.
So just a minute, sir. So this can show GI.
No. Done? Next to write down. Note on this point. Dehydrohalogenation of alkyl fluoride. Dehydrohalogenation of alkyl fluoride follows less substituted product. Dehydrohalogenation of alkyl fluoride follows less substituted product. So here the less substituted means Hoffman only is the major product. Why? Suppose we have a reaction CH3 CHF CH2 CH3. Suppose this is the alkyl fluoride we have. Now when the reaction takes place with a base called CH3O minus, and when the base is CH3O minus, what is the solvent? CH3OH is the solvent we use. Okay. Yeah, base.
Alkyl chloride.
Chloride also you can use. Cover you with bromine is chloride. Means generally these reactions are true for bromine and fluorine, alkyl bromide and alkyl fluoride. But in case of fluorine, sorry, alkyl bromide and chloride. But in case of fluoride, the product is different. Okay. So the first example that we took for alkyl bromide, same thing we'll have for chloride also. Okay, no change.
Chloride. Chloride
and bromide is same. Okay. No, it's fluoride. Fluoride we have.
Fluoride.
No, no, fluoride. I said fluoride, right?
Yeah, you said fluoride.
Fluoride. CH3, CHF, CH2, CH3. Fluoride. Okay. So in this case, the major product is CH2 double bond, CH, CH2, CH3. And the minor one is CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3. This is major and this is minor. The reason for this is, since carbon chlorine fluorine bond is strong, stronger than carbon chlorine or bromine. Okay, so what happens, this CH2 hydrogen, this carbon here, is the intermediate stage. One more intermediate, wrong. Draw this first. Okay. Now in this what happens, fluorine has poor leaving tendency in comparison of leaving. Yes. Iodine is the best, I minus the best halide ion, leaving group. Okay. This has the least leaving tendency out of the four halogen atom. And more electronegative this one, least leaving tendency. So it actually what it does, it delayed the extraction of H plus from the beta carbon. Okay. So it's not like this base will take this H plus directly and goes off, right? So we'll have an intermediate stage form into this one, like this delta negative charge forms over here during the base which extracts H plus from the beta carbon. So like this and this, the two possibility we have where this delta negative charge forms on the carbon atom intermediate, right? So this is a characteristics of carbon ion, right? Carbon ion characteristics develop. Carbon ion nature, because of this, poor leaving tendency of F minus. This is the carbon ion tendency develops here and here also. Now in this one and this one, if you compare, this is 1 degree carbon ion and this one is 2 degree carbon ion. Which one is more stable? First one is more stable. That's why this is more stable and hence this one is the major problem. Reason is it forms an intermediate carbon ion. Okay, it's not the completely developed carbon ion, we call it as non-classical carbon ion. Okay, partial negative charge, non-classical carbon ion. Delta negative, delta negative.
Both ways. Sounds like delta negative both ways.
Delta negative.
So it's asking how can both be delta negative?
See, actually this was the negative already. It tries to take this H plus, right? When this H plus is going away, this carbon has this two electron. So charge is developing onto this, and it is not like the charge is developing. It goes off, and this charge comes over here, then F minus goes off. So. Okay, right on. Next point. If there is possibility of forming conjugated alkene, then we always form conjugated alkene as the major product.
So irrespective of everything else.
Yes. Because of conjugation the alkene becomes more stable. That's why. Okay, suppose you see this example, we have CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2 CH fluorine, CH2 CH3 with C2H5 O minus and C2H5 OH. Tell me the major product here.
So the double bond will come at the third one. CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2 double bond CH.
H2 are the beta carbon, right?
Yes, sir. So they will come on the left side.
Double bond here and here. That is the two
possibilities.
This double bond is in conjugation with this double. So the product is, the major product is CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH double bond, CH single bond, CH2 CH. This is the major product. Okay. Now these are the reactions you must remember. Slightly we will discuss even mechanism also.
So then if there are two conjugations possible,
we'd
always go with extended conjugation.
Yes. Cross extended is always more stable than cross. Even mechanism you see, suppose we have an alkyne line, CH3 and Br. You see, tertiary alkyne line. So it favors the elimination reaction, tertiary alkyne line. So when this reaction takes place at a certain temperature, this Br minus goes out. Right, and forms a carbocation. Like I said, even reaction is what? Two-step reaction. So first step, we'll get a carbocation, positive charge, and Br- goes into those also. Okay, now the next step, since we always use this, do this reaction in a polar solvent, and suppose you are having water here, H2O. So water here behaves as a base, and it takes H plus from this carbon. H plus extracted. This first carbocation forms, then this will extract the H plus. This bond pair comes over here and forms a double bond. So product of this reaction is CH3CCH3 double bond. Even mechanism is first step carbocation forms, reversible reaction, and then the polar solvent takes H plus from the alpha carbon, sorry, beta carbon. Next, write down next reaction. We use this extraction of H plus is there. So we use a solvent which may behave as a base, as lone pair. That's why you see amine we have, trihyl amine.
Ah, so when it's losing the H, what is the H?
कुछ नहीं H plus लेके H3O plus बनाया ठीक है that H plus combines with Br forms HBr. Elimination process.
Sir, E2 reaction also when we get
into
an H and a.
हाँ so it is dehydrohalogenation HX का removal so it always forms.
Hydrogen will bond with chlorine or bromine or whatever.
Yes, HCl HBr. Okay, next write down dehydration of alcohol. Next reaction depression of alkene. Dehydration of alcohol. Write down. Dehydration of alcohol.
Reaction
reversible.
What? Like this one.
First step, where the carbocation is formed. That is reversible. First step. Write down. Dehydration of alcohol takes place in presence of an acid. An acid, and generally we use what? Concentrated H2SO4. Any acid which can produce proton H plus, and hence this reaction is known as acid catalyzed.
So is it concentrated acid? Or
concentrated. This reaction is known as acid catalyzed dehydration. And hence this reaction is known as acid catalyzed dehydration. See, one thing I forgot to tell you, the first reaction we have done E2 elimination. E2 elimination, we also call it as a 1,2 elimination. Same thing. 1,2 elimination. And since it extracts H plus from the beta carbon, we also call it as beta elimination here. Both are all are same thing. Beta elimination. 1,2 elimination or beta elimination here. Write on dehydration of alcohol. Write on.
So all
beta elimination.
So all of them are beta elimination.
All of them means what? E2 eliminations are beta elimination.
So but is E1 also beta?
E1 generally it is two step reaction. So in the second step the carbocation forms, and then we take alpha hydrogen from there. So with respect to carbocation, the carbon which loses hydrogen is the alpha carbon. That's why we are not calling them as beta elimination. Write down dehydration of alcohol. This reaction forms a carbocation intermediate. Right. This reaction forms a carbocation intermediate, and then from the alpha carbon, H plus goes out to form an alkene. Carbocation intermediate, and then from alpha carbon, H plus goes out to form an alkene. Okay. Suppose the reaction is CH3 CH2. This is the reaction we have, and we are using concentrated H2SO4 for this reaction. Okay, acid means H plus, Now, what is the use of this acid, H+? The use of acid is that it protonates this oxygen, loses H+, and this oxygen takes H+ from this acid. Okay? So, protonation of hydroxy group takes place and it forms CH3CHOH2, positive charge, CH3. Okay? Now, the advantage of this is what? OH minus, we know it is a poor living group, but H2O is a good living group, right? So, this cannot go out as OH minus, but when it protonates, this H2O goes out as a neutral molecule and it forms a carbocation that is CH positive charge, CH3 plus H2O. Okay? What is the last step? Last step is what? From any one of these carbon atoms, suppose here, C2 and H. This takes this H plus, leaving this bond pair behind, and it forms CH3CH double bond CH2 plus. See, actually when, you know the structure of H2SO4, S double bond O, double bond O, OH and OH, right? So these are acidic hydrogen, this one and this one. So when this goes out, we have O minus and SO3H is left. So this is the conjugate base we have. So this O minus takes this H plus, forms H2SO4 and dialkene forms it. Okay?
So if it's not symmetrical, then which one will it attack on?
I'm coming to that. Okay. Now you see, in this reaction, the carbocation is forming as an intermediate. And in all those reactions where carbocation is forming, we always try to get the most possible stable carbocation by rearranging. Okay. So in this, rearrangement of carbocation is possible in order to get the most stable carbocation. Rearrangement of carbocation possible. Okay, this is true for all those reactions where carbocation is forming as an intermediate.